All right. Today, we're going to dig into a really interesting question about money. It seems like it should have a simple answer, but it's way more complicated than you think. When we talk about a country's currency, is weaker actually better?
I mean, let's think about this. We hear it all the time, right? People on the news talking about a strong economy, a strong dollar. And our gut just tells us, hey, strong is good, weak is bad. But when it comes to economics, is it really that black and white?
Okay, so before we can even answer that question, we all have to be on the same page about the most basic idea here, the exchange rate. It sounds super technical, I know, but it's not. All it is a price tag. It's simply the price you pay in your money to buy one unit of someone else's money.
Let's use a real-world example to make this stick. To buy one single US dollar, you would need 3.65 Israeli shekels. That's it. That number, 3.65, that's the exchange rate. And you're going to want to keep that number in mind because it's the key to everything else we're about to talk about.
So, let's put this idea into action. We're going to start by looking at what happens when a local currency gets weaker. The fancy economic term for this is devaluation.
So what does that actually mean? Well, devaluation is just when the price tag on foreign money goes up. You have to hand over more of your local cash, in this case more shekels, to get that very same US dollar. Your money's worth a little less.
Okay, so let's walk through a quick example. Remember our starting point. One US dollar costs 3.65 shekels.
Now let's just imagine the shekel devalues by 10%. The math here is pretty simple. We take our original rate, 3.65, and we just multiply it by 1.10.
And voila, we get a new number, 4.015. So after that 10% devaluation, that same US dollar now costs more shekels to buy. The number went up, and that means the shekel got weaker.
So let's just hammer this home. The shekel has weakened, and from the other side of the coin, you could say the dollar has gotten stronger. But the bottom line, if you're holding shekels, is that you now need more of them to buy that $1.
Okay, so we've seen what happens when a currency weakens. Now let's flip the script. What does it look like when a currency gets stronger? Well, this is called appreciation.
And as you've probably already figured out, appreciation is the exact opposite of devaluation. It means your local money is getting stronger, so you need fewer of your own bills to buy that same unit of foreign currency. The price tag on foreign money went down.
So let's run the numbers one more time. This time, let's imagine a 5% appreciation of the shekel. We take our base rate of 3.65 and multiply it by 0.95.
And we get a new, lower number. $1 now only costs about 3.47 shekels. The price of the dollar went down for you because your currency got stronger. Makes sense, right?
So here's a perfect side-by-side to really lock this in. Devaluation. Your money gets weaker, so you need more of it to buy foreign currency. Appreciation. Your money gets stronger, so you need fewer. They're just two sides of the same coin. Literally.
Okay, so we've got the mechanics down. We know the difference between a weak currency and a strong one. And that brings us right back to our huge multi-billion dollar question, which one is actually better for the economy?
And this is the twist. The answer might actually surprise you. From a big picture macroeconomic point of view, especially when we're talking about jobs, a weaker currency is often considered better for the economy. I know, it feels totally backwards, but why?
Well, let's break it down. There's a real logic to it. It's not random at all. A weaker currency actually kicks off this powerful chain reaction throughout the entire economy.
So here's how that chain reaction plays out. It all starts when the currency weakens. All of a sudden, local companies that sell their stuff to other countries find that their exports are way more profitable. So what do? They hire more workers to make more stuff. At the exact same time, all those foreign goods, the imports, get more expensive for people at home. So what do? They start buying more locally made products, and that boosts local production and creates even more jobs.
And you can see this whole dynamic perfectly on this chart. Devaluation acts like a shot in the arm for exports and local businesses, driving them up. And at the same time, it puts the brakes on imports, pushing them down. The overall effect is this big shift towards more jobs and more business happening right at home.
So it really boils down to these two huge effects. One, it boosts exports because a company selling something for, say, $100 gets more local money back in their pocket. That encourages them to hire. And two, it reduces imports because that new smartphone or that German car just got more expensive.
Of course, there's a trade-off. More expensive imports can lead to inflation. But if your main goal is creating jobs, both of these effects lead to more local employment.
And this isn't just some theory in a textbook. This economic logic is exactly why a country's central bank might actively and intentionally try to weaken its own currency. It's not a sign of failure. It's a strategic move. It's a tool they can use to fight unemployment.
And that really brings us to the main takeaway here. Thinking about a currency's strength as just good or bad is kind of missing the point. It isn't a simple report card on how well an economy is doing. It's really a powerful lever, a tool, that policymakers can pull to achieve very specific goals, like creating jobs.
And that leaves us with a final question to chew on. A strong currency gets you cheaper imports and more affordable vacations, but a weak currency might create more jobs in your community, even if it makes those imported goods a little pricier. So what really matters more? Cheaper stuff for you or more jobs for everyone? That's the fundamental trade-off that sits right at the heart of all of this.